Who are you?
I'm Check, Check, Check. Hmm.
You are?
Pharrell.
From the?
From the group NERD.
NERD, and Pharrell, who do you have beside you?
Shay.
Hello, Shay.
What's going on, Nard? $100 bills, look.
$100 bills, look. Welcome to Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada.
Yeah, it feels good to be here.
It's Nardwar.
Nardwar, the human serviette.
Serviette. Okay. Is Nardwar one word or two words?
One word.
Nardwar. And what's the origin of this?
Nardwar is like a dumb, stupid name like Sting. And human is from the band The Cramps, their song Human Fly. And in the United States of America, you don't have serviettes, you have napkins. So I'm Nardwar, a human serviette.
Oh, so the human napkin.
Yes, exactly. And the human.
So what does Nardwar mean, though?
It's just a dumb, stupid, made-up name, like Sebado, Sting, Sinbad. You know what I mean? It's a dumb, stupid name.
Yeah, but Sting has a real, like, there's a definition for it. Is there a definition for it?
Well, no, there isn't. Although there is a record label recently that sprung up called Jag 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 Jaguar. And I was really kind of jealous of that, thinking they're stealing my shtick there, calling the record label that. But no, it's just a dumb, stupid name.
Really? So there's no dictionary definition?
No, I was just talking to myself one day, groveling, like, Nardwar! It is kind of like nerdy, isn't it? Like, I mean, in a way, N-E-R-D, you know, Nardwar! We both share N's together. Sorry for not acknowledging that.
No, that's great. I think that's cool.
And I would like to welcome you, N-E-R-D, to Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada, with a gift. And we have it right here. This is a book, Skateboarding Vancouver, for you, Pharrell and Shay. And this celebrates skateboarding in Vancouver and the history of skateboarding as well.
Wow. The shape of that board right there is like when I was skating when I was a kid.
Hey, Nard, I think you should be in the next NERD video.
Absolutely.
I'm there! Superstar asking what you have. Martin and Kendra and B just laugh. Oh, what can you tell me about the importance of Carl Sagan and the music of the cosmos?
I cannot believe you have this in album form.
This is Carl Sagan doing the throwdown.
How?
Well, of course I bought it when it came out. There it is, the gatefold as well. What can you tell the people about Carl Sagan, Pharrell?
I'm blown away right now. I can't believe you have this on wax. I'm blown away. This is incredible.
Well, I'm so glad that you're into it because I am too. It's an amazing record, isn't it? There's Carl Sagan kicking it down. You've not seen this before on wax?
Absolutely not.
Well, what about you, Shay?
Never. First time.
Wow, and there it is. So how does it play into the NERD formula, or the Pharrell formula?
God. I don't know, man. I can only aspire to be, you know, someone that people learn as much as they've learned from Carl Sagan. Carl Sagan is to me what Tribe Called Quest was to us for music. Before this, did you really know what I was?
Comprehend to the track force, why, cuz? One genius guy is missing, though. You're into the Carl Sagan. What does this particular person right here, Mr. Mindy and Mork, represent, Shay, to the member that's not here?
Chad would die right now.
He would.
Why would Chad die over this particular thing right here? Could you explain, Pharrell?
Well, Mork from Ork, we grew up to that. We grew up with that. And, you know, Mork and Mindy was Nanu Nanu.
So Nanu Nanu plus Carl Sagan equals?
NERD. What can you say?
All the girls standing in the line for the bathroom.
You guys played Virginia recently, and when you played Virginia NERD, you did a shout out to the Military Circle Mall.
Yeah, we did.
We did.
Yeah.
How'd you catch that?
What do you know about the Military Circle Mall? What can you tell the people at the Military Circle Mall and NERD?
Well, that's a mall back home where we're from, where, like, it's a little bit more urbanized and, like, you know, it's where all the cute black girls go.
That's where everything was laid down in Virginia. And I wanted to ask you, particularly Pharrell, about this joint right here. Is this where it all started right here with the rump shaker? Pharrell, is this where it started? Pharrell Williams, the rump shaker.
Yeah. This is one of the most impressive interviews I've ever experienced in my life. Seriously.
Well, thank you so much. It's great to be able to talk to you guys.
This is insane, man. Do you see this?
What?
Who comes to an interview and hands you, skateboarding Vancouver style? Mork and Mindy Dahl, music of the cosmos, and a Rum Shaker record.
Me, Nardwuar, a human serviette, entering NER?
D. Stands for damn.
It's Teddy, ready with the 1-2 checker. Rex in the fences in the fence, but I'm the wrecker.
What do you remember about this particular joint, the Rump Shaker, Pharrell? You got your name in print, that's cool, from 1992.
I'm bugging out. I can't believe he has this. I just remember being a kid in high school and definitely unfocused, so I had like another year to go. And when this record came out, it was like, it was an amazing feeling. You know, I was from Virginia Beach, Virginia, where there wasn't really a music industry at all.
That's the Mount Trashmore skate park. That's a neat name, isn't it, Shay?
Absolutely.
Mount Trashmore. Was there a rumor once that Mount Trashmore was going to blow up and people got scared?
No, not that
there was a rumor.
Was it?
Yo, this is really scary. Yeah, people thought that, like, the gases from all the trash.
The landfill?
Yeah. Somehow was going to explode.
Like a DJ started some sort of rumor on the radio. It's like a War of the Worlds.
Your research is second to none. Second to none. And I can only imagine that you probably do the same kind of research with every band that you interview. So it's pretty impressive, man.
Well, thank you. I really appreciate that, NRRD, Pharrell, and Shay. That's very nice of you to say that. And I will launch right into the Chuck Norris Karate Studio.
Now you're playing dirty. Now you're playing dirty.
Now you're playing dirty. Why would you do that?
Well, I guess I was curious. The Chuck Norris Karate Studio. Is Chuck Norris actually at that karate studio? Because I noticed there's a Chuck Norris Karate Studio in Virginia, but he's not there, is he?
No, he's not. He came one time, though.
Yeah.
When I was a kid.
It caused some problems. How's that playing dirty, Shay?
I don't know. How's that playing dirty, bro?
Because it's embarrassing. That's why.
Kia! You guys are called NERD.
Yes, sir.
Also in Virginia, and you're from Virginia, there's ARE, Edward Casey.
Wow. Mm. Okay.
Which stands for the Association of Research and Enlightenment.
Yeah, I go there all the time.
That's sort of interesting. What do you think about ARE? What can you tell people about Edward Casey?
He was a renowned sleeping psychic. He was interesting the way he, came across his and conjured his information. But there's a lot of holistic education you can get there. It's pretty interesting.
Did you ever hang out at Aladdin's Castle Video Arcade at all?
Yeah.
Was that a good chain?
It was cool. After you go to Japan, nothing matters anymore though.
Yeah.
Japan is like, they have that's like video game capital to me.
There's a town, wipe your face, cool down, have a drink, it's on me.
Pharrell, you designed a chair, an amazing looking chair. Is the NERD faux next?
Not an NERD phone, but I gotta say, it's pretty scary. You're either psychic or like, I don't know. Like, you have some kind of remote viewing talent or something. Seriously, it's amazing.
Well, thank you. Remote viewing.
Yeah, I'm a fan.
Here's a towel, wipe your face, cool down, but you would rather party, cuz.
Well, thanks very much, NERD. Keep on rocking in the free world and do 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 loot do.
Do do.